20 hindsight, it was clear that Evander Kane just wasn't going to work in Winnipeg. Friendly Manitoba never really warmed to him, and the rumors about his off-ice behavior were way more interesting to fans than even that 30-goal season he had in 2011 and 12. Now Kane is Buffalo's problem slash 23-year-old with 40-goal potential. The big trade going down on Wednesday. Kane with defenseman Zach Bogosian and unsigned goalie prospect to Buffalo in exchange for defenseman Tyler Myers, Drew Stafford, a couple of extra players, and a 2015 first-round pick. Stafford, an unrestricted free agent after this season. Kane has 3 years remaining on his deal, 5.25 per year. Bogosian, 4 years remaining on his contract. With more, we go to Sean Churchill.
In today's NHL, which is ruled by the salary cap, even Kevin Cheveldayoff is surprised that he was able to build a blockbuster trade so quickly. One that sent Evander Kane and Zach Bogosian to Buffalo for four players and a first-round draft pick.
It's not easy to make deals, in this league. There's, prices and values and timing and, rosters and all the different things. So, the ability to add right now was very important.
I like Evander Kane, and I'm happy for him. We made it work as well as it could. And then an opportunity came along, especially with Evander's injury, for us to get better by adding players to our team.
Cheveldayoff would not confirm that last week's off-ice incident regarding Kane and his former teammates, which ended in Kane being a healthy scratch, added any pressure to make a move.
It was a situation where I wanted to look at the best interests of the organization, and there was an opportunity here to address something right now and to address something, for the future. And it wasn't the sake of, like I always said, of a deal for making a deal.
I've heard some hearsay and stuff like that, and a little bit that happened in Winnipeg, but I see a guy on the ice that plays like that. I have to assume that he is at least somewhat like that off the ice. And I'm excited to have a player like that come in here.
The Jets play in Nashville on Thursday, where Tyler Myers and Drew Stafford are expected to join the team.
We're such a tight-knit group. We take care of our own. I think you've heard the word family a number of times, and we got two new members of our family. So, they're going to come right in, and we're going to try to get them fit in right as fast as possible.
It's not an easy day for those guys and for our team as a whole. It's part of it, though. We realize that we're losing two guys that were a big part of our team. But we're going to welcome some new guys in.
It'll be a while until it's determined which team got the better of this deal. The Buffalo Sabres will not see Evander Kane until next season. He's currently recovering from season-ending shoulder surgery. Sean Churchill, TSN, Winnipeg.
Much love, Sean Churchill. Evander Kane gave an interview with Pierre LeBrun, said, I'm excited, very excited about the trade. It's nice to go somewhere where you feel wanted and you feel that they want to put you in a situation to have success. It was definitely disappointing with how everything shook out and some of the information was misconstrued, misleading. Some of the facts came out wrong or didn't come out at all. That's to be expected, but I'm definitely glad to be moving on and I'm going to have a fresh start with a new team. Looking forward to the future for sure. That some people thought I was having surgery just to end my season. That's so not true. That's the biggest thing I want to make clear. With more on the deal, here's Rod, Bob, and Darren.
We had a feeling the way it went last week for Evander Kane and the Winnipeg Jets, there would be a deal sooner rather than later, perhaps even sooner than many expected with it being done to Buffalo just a week later. Bob, how impactful is this trade for the Jets?
Well, Rod, it's huge. I mean, you've really got to hand it to Winnipeg general manager Kevin Cheveldayoff. Not only was he trading a player who's just underwent shoulder surgery and is out 4 to 6 months, which took out more than half the teams in the National Hockey League that were interested in him, but he also traded a player who had some pretty big question marks about his off-ice conduct and how he got along with teammates. And in return, he got a very fair value, if not better than fair. In Drew Stafford, they get a third-line winger. They can plug into the hole where Evander Kane was right away, help them down the stretch, help them make the playoffs. If Evander Kane goes on to score all sorts of goals for the Buffalo Sabres, they got enough in the way of future considerations with a talented young forward like Joel Armia, who's very inconsistent but has some offensive ability, and Brendan Lemieux, son of the past Claude Lemieux, who looks like he'll project out as a very good agitating third line winger in the National Hockey League. So there's something for now, there's something for later, and then of course there's the big swap of the defensemen. But just in general terms, Kevin Cheveldayoff was in a real tough spot, and he took the Louisville off his shoulder, and he swung for the fences, and he did very well.
Well, NHL sources say that Cheveldayoff reached out to a number of general managers midweek last week to say that Evander Kane would most definitely be on the market and was available for trade. So at that point, I'm sure Tim Murray of the Buffalo Sabres jumped in along with other general managers to get this process rolling. But it's not just about the assets that are required to help this team now and the future. As Bob talked about, there's plenty of that to go around for the Winnipeg Jets. It's also about a cash savings. Now, there are similar cap hits, but when you look at the dollars here, Myers comes in, 4 years remaining, $15.5 million owing. Bogosian goes out, 5 years remaining on his contract, and $28 million owing. Plus, the Sabres retain half of Drew Stafford's salary. So there's an investment to be made moving forward, either in a free agent to maybe cover off for Evander Kane or other deals that need to be made. But from a financial standpoint, the Jets also did very well.
Absolutely. The bottom line is Winnipeg is very happy for what this does for the present and their playoff push for the future as well. Bob, what about the Buffalo Sabres? Obviously not worrying about the immediate future, looking down the road. How important is this deal to them?
Well, I like the deal from the Buffalo Sabres. There's a little risk involved, and that risk is Evander Kane. What's Evander Kane going to be? Is he going to go back to being the 30-goal man that he was projected to be, an elite-level guy with speed and skill and strength and all those elements that could make him one of the better power forwards in the National Hockey League? That's the thing that Tim Murray is counting on, that he went out and got this guy. Now, keep in mind, Evander Kane is going to have a much bigger role on the Buffalo Sabres than he would on the Winnipeg Jets, and that he'll likely be lining up with either Connor McDavid or Jack Eichel as a centerman. The Sabres are going to finish in last place. They're going to end up with one of those two generational talents in the middle, and Kane's going to have a big role. This also helps to accelerate the rebuilding plan for the Buffalo Sabres to put a 23-year-old like Kane, who is a credible National Hockey League player with the potential to score 30 or 40 goals, instead of waiting for Joel Armia or Brendan Lemieux to come along. I like it from the Sabres because it gives them a chance to be a little bit better or a lot better in the very short near future.
I wonder if it'll accelerate more trades between now and the deadline.
It could. The sellers are most definitely getting anxious now in light of this mega deal, and the buyers are also getting a bit nervous because, you know, particularly if you're in the Western Conference, you see what Winnipeg has done to load up here for their postseason push. Well, teams might want to respond. If you're Arizona, you've got your pending list of unrestricted free agents, starting with Antoine Vermette. You've got to deal with those, and the Toronto Maple Leafs are another team that are probably feeling a little antsy after this deal.
Yeah, trade season is certainly here, and what a way to get it started. Our Hockey Insiders, Darren Dreger and Bob McKenzie.